I'm Dominic, and this is writing SELinux raw policy anywhere part 3. So whilst I was encoding and uploading part 2, I was reminded of another issue of assumption that I did, and that has to be as that is related to the set and see file context. Whoops. So I'll just open up our file context file. And so as you might remember, I had some issues with specifying the file contexts because I was using some readable policy configuration macros that I shouldn't have because I'm writing raw policy configuration. Anyways, so this security context, as you might be aware, is has four fields right here, and each field in the security context basically is in use by a security model. For example, the system view field is used by the identity based access control model, and sometimes optionally the user based access control model. In this case it isn't, but that's also an assumption. The object the role field, in this case object R, this field isn't used by the role based access control model, and the third field, the type field, is used by the type enforcement security model. And the fourth field is an optional field, just like, or it's an optional field, and it's used by the multi-category security policy security model, or the multi-level security policy model. So basically the assumption that I made was that I knew that this field was even used, because if, for example, the policy model, security model, did not implement the fourth field, then I shouldn't specify a fourth field in the security context tuple in the file context file. So basically how you can verify that, whether you need to set that fourth field or not, is basically simply by listing a file. For example, I'll list all the files in this directory, and as you can see, I use the capital Z to list the security context, and as you can see, this security context has four fields and has this fourth field set, and basically that tells me that the fourth field isn't used for a security model, whether that is multi-category security or multi-level security or whatever other security model that might be implemented that is using this fourth field. I don't know. I could of course check that out with SE status, sudo SE status, and SE info would also give me that information. So it's basically, oh no, it's basically saying policy name is targeted, but it's not telling me anything about the policy of the security model. It does tell me that the security context do have the fourth field, so let's see what SE info has to say. Let's see, this does tell us something. For example, the policy version and type, and it says here the type is a binary multi-level security policy, but that doesn't say anything about whether it's multi-category security or multi-level security. It basically says that the fourth field is used, but these fields here tell me that it is indeed the existing multi-category security, because multi-category security only has one sensitivity as opposed to multi-level security, which has one or more sensitivities. And so this tells me that this uses the known existing multi-category security security model. But anyway, so just so you know that how you can figure that out, whether you should define a fourth field or not. Okay, so where was I? I was in the previous video, I was basically dealing with optional policy dependencies for modular policy environment. So let's finish that up. And that was set and see type enforcement file. And I already dealt with some stuff, which, for example, the user home type could be optional. This type could also be optional. This attribute could also be optional. The application domain type. So we could basically also make that optional. Although, well, we can verify that first. Application sudo sudo l, and I know that this attribute is declared in the application module, and that's also an assumption that I make. Unfortunately, this is not something you can do on a system that you don't know. But anyways, just as an example, I'll just do it optional, because this module can also be used that's what we're going to implement later as a system service. So it doesn't have to be a user application domain. So this module could work without a application domain type classification and without the application module install. So remove that application executable domain type, and also the executable application executable type can also be done. Type attribute domain is in the base. It's not optional, I think. You could check that out. It shouldn't be optional, because without the domain, it's domain module, it wouldn't work. And these are other domains. It's not the domain module, so that's not optional. You need it, because if that module isn't there, then nothing's going to apply. These attributes, all four, are not optional, because they are part, and that's also an assumption, part of the files module, which is in base as well, which is compiled in the base module, which is a module that has the mandatory modules. Modules that are not optional. So Okay, application exec type. Oops. It's a bit, I'll clean this up later. These are probably not optional. The boolean member may be optional, but I'll just leave that as mandatory. I'll also remove that from the application domain type from the normal requirements. Okay, so what else is optional? These are not optional, these attributes here are part of the network, core network module, which are also mandatory, these are all, or not all, not all. So the third is optional, so optional require attribute and yield type, sorry, this is a type, cert and then just ident is indent. Etc type is part of the files module, which is not optional. Gatekeeper port T is not optional, it's part of the core network port. Locale is optional because it's part of the MISC files module, which in practice should probably should always be there, but you could uninstall it if you want to, I guess. And if you can verify that by using SE module L-L to verify that, but I'm pretty sure that it's optional, and basically it doesn't really hurt to make something optional. Netconfig is of the sysnet module, is also an assumption again, but it's optional. Require type netconfig. And then indent. Close it. The node T type is mandatory, it's also in the core network module. The proc T type is also mandatory, it's in the kernel module. Self, these rules should go up, but I'll leave them there, but that's also mandatory. Z&C port in this case is a local type. Urandom is part of the device module, which is also mandatory. User dev PTST is probably part of the user domain module. So first I'll remove that netconf here. And that user dev PTS, also remove that. I think, yeah, that's probably also. And I also remove the user home grid T because it's also of the user domain. So the user dev PTST is basically part of the user domain module, which is optional. Type user dev. Because if you basically use this module just for a system service, then you won't have to interact with the user domain. So you, in theory, you won't even need a user domain module installed if this would be a system without users. Although in practice, of course, the system without users doesn't exist. But anyways. Optional. Require. Type. User. Home. Dirty. Okay. So, and this is also optional. Although, basically, these two rules won't apply. Well, they can apply, but they won't apply. So I'll just put this up. Right there, because same requirement. They could apply if you, for example, install the .7c directory and then just use restore to reset the context, then it could, in theory, apply. Anyway, so now we made our module basically deal with with dependency issues in a modular environment. See if it builds. Syntax error app token with locality. So where do I have locality? Right. It's a brackets too much. It's loading. And install it. So it's installing, and now it should be pretty much compatible with the modular environment. So if you install any of these optional modules, it should be able to do that, although your policy module supports that part where it requires on the other optional module, but at least you'll be able to uninstall it, deinstall it, and then basically you can tune your policy to behave in the new environment, in the same environment with the new properties, because your environment properties will change if you deinstall a module where your module depends on. So next thing I will do when this installs is I will see if I can support ident, because this bouncer seems to be able to interact with ident daemons. So hopefully that's not too hard. Actually, last thing I remembered, that this environment doesn't have the module that I would like to use. This takes a while. Phew. Because I, in a while ago, I wrote a policy for oident sudo basic module list and then grep for ident. but Fedora hadn't installed it for some stupid reason. See? That's so stupid. And these are only the active modules, not the module. So they won't have the ident. Empty. That is so messed up. It's also empty. This actually does have the interface file for our ident daemon, but it's just not installed. And for some reason, this won't work either. So that's messed up, pissing me off. So it's this package is not available, so that blows. Okay, let's just I removed the .setnc directory because I want to recreate that config file so that I can disable IP version 6 because I don't have that. Well, I do have it, but I prefer to use IP version 4. So setnc. And what was it? Make config, I guess. Make config. I do have that in my. Yeah, this is the part about oident. I looked it up. See if make config works. Yep. No, it doesn't. Make conf. I'll just use something. Yeah, I'd like to be an administrator. Yeah, ident. That's not going to work now, is it? Oh, bind host. Number of lines. Okay. It's listening. Is it? Yeah, it's listening here on all local IP addresses. Now let's see if I can actually connect to it, or let's see if that web interface works. Also, but more important is to see if there are any recent ABC denials. Nope, none. So we took care of that properly. See if I can connect to it. This connection is trusted. Add exception. Not permanently. Welcome to SELinux web interface, and then I get a valid login. Oh. So this is the web interface. Do we have any new ABC denials? Yep, we do. But to either to allow. Unable to open. Ain't that something? That's something. And I'm not root. Now it's not stupid. So we have some stuff that we need to add. And has to is related to the etc file. I thought. No, use a TCP socket, and this is totally new. So the user is also user T is also a type defined in the file module. That's also an assumption. So we need to require type user T. And we need to TCP socket. Get attribute and accept. Get attribute. attribute and accept, and then just extend that. We have the other stuff, self, TCP socket, get attribute, accept, get attribute, accept. So it's accepting that connection there. So updated. Let's have a look at that web interface. Web admin module, global settings. Fail to ban support. Allow users to authenticate via SSL certificates. Also cool. Log events to a file or syslog. Oh, that's cool. So basically, this is all stuff that need to be supported from a SELinux point of view. There should be some help here, because how do I specify whether I want to log to syslog or... Oh, it has a wiki. Admin log. So, let's see. File, syslog, or both. I wonder whether I could specify a path. But I'll just add syslog for a moment just to see if that works. Save. Syslog. My settings. Okay, and then the home. So, is there a way to restart this thing, or did it already restart? That's stupid. So if I pipe, then there's some file descriptor issue. And now we have some other stuff. So it's deleting. Deleting, and it's appending. I wonder what that's all about. Grab append. Hopefully not logs. Yep, stupid. I specified it to log to syslog, and it doesn't. It logs to setnc log. Stupid. But we'll need to support it and. Basically, buggy as hell. So, file append. And then just add the append to the setnc file. We could make this much more secure. Rename and unlink files, so it wants to rename and delete a file. We could make this much more secure. Rename and link. But that's also depending on our goals. What do we want to achieve? So basically, it's always a good idea to not allow setnc to write to its logs, and it needs to remove a dir, or remove a dir entry, sorry. And I'll also add that to the class dir. Basically, what we could do is basically just not allow ZNC underscore T domain to write to its log files, but just append so that it cannot erase its trail. So that when for some reason ZNC becomes a compromise, that it at least cannot erase its trail, so that we can see from a logging perspective what actually happened. Now, what I find stupid is that syslog annoying. Maybe it's target syslog. I doubt it. Now that may be some. I would argue a discretionary access control issue, but it isn't, because unprivileged users should also be allowed to use syslog. So something fishy going on in here. It might just be that I don't know how to configure it. Or it might just be a bug. Blocks the users from logging in, collects data, and write the ident of a user to a file when they are trying to connect. Block IPs for some time after failed login, which is failed to ban. Blocks certain users from logging in. Disallow IP changing during the web session. Okay, anyways, let's try and connect to this mother. Add a new network. ZNC BNC and then edit it. Oops, remove, and it's port and server is 192.168.1.101. Connect to the selected server only. Use global. Nope. Nickname is 123. It's 123. Put in underscore. Username 123. Real name 123. Auto connect to this network and startup. Use SSL for all servers. Accept invalid SSL certificate. Unreserved password. Not sure, but I'll just enter my password in here. So you can see I'm connected using SSL. It's still no new ABC denials. I didn't edit, didn't go to a channel. And how does this work? Message. Well, a lot of options, but anyways, this works, but we need support for fail-to-ban, which I'm hesitant to install, and we need support for ident. But I'll leave that up to as an exercise for the user. Message module name command. Send see help. See if it. Ah, there we go. So this basically gives me the bouncer options. The following list of occurrences of chance port blah 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 blah. Okay, so fine, it works. So we made the optional stuff optional. We added some support for logging. We didn't use some super nice features such as names type transition. So that's basically a type transition where you can specify a name so that it only transitions to a specified type if the name matches the of the created content, which would be a nice feature to implement if it was for a for the log file, which we could do. And we also should implement a boolean for allowing ZNC to bind TCP sockets to any unreserved ports rather than only the ZNC port, the port type, so that you can basically tune it to be functional for mass host environment, mass host environments. But one thing is what's really annoying is that I don't have a confined ident. I could get it from the website, I guess I could, so maybe I should. First off, commit this, because basically this is our initial ZNC domain. Git commit. bit confused, so right. Oh, I need to add that stuff. And then commit it. And I thought I excluded. Mod file. Fix. Okay, so that should fix that. So what I was saying is that I should get that module from the website and this incorporated. So I'll get it from the Git repository upstream. Now this is basically not applicable to this tutorial, but I would like to make it work. Oident. There it is. And this is human readable policy as opposed to what we did raw policy. So you can see the difference here. Copy that over. I'll just create a new dir. I don't. Well, actually, dir. Oh, I can't. Oh, I can't. And then okay, ignore. Type enforcement file and just paste it. Oops. explicit stuff in there. You still hungry there. Are you kidding me? Need to use home content. Are you kidding me? That is so messy. I don't know what the hell they did with this policy. They raped it. They raped it. I wrote this policy unfortunately upstream. OSS traces from projects ref policy. So messed up that you're working in a policy that you don't agree with, and then this might not work. See, this doesn't work. Some breakage in there. So I'll just forget about this oident support. Unfortunate, but I guess there's no other way. So what we can do is basically add support for a system service. But I'll leave that for another example.